All right, cool. So today is Monday, the 28th, and I'm going to share with you guys my entire screen so you guys could see the notes. All right, can you guys see the screen? People, can you see the notes called OneNotes? All right, cool. Thank you. Thank you. All right, so this is business math. We're going to go all the way down here. And I was going some of the over some of the quizzes. So today, go ahead and write this down. It should be a pretty simple lesson today. All right. So this one is September 28, which is Monday. Okay. And this is another criteria to buy a house. Okay. So this one's going to be called debt. Debt. You don't pronounce the B. So a debt, it's just silent. Debt to income ratio. Okay. So go ahead and write that down real quick. Remember, it's gonna be on the note. It's gonna be on the whatchamacallit. What? Yes. Well, you don't even do work, so I don't know why you're complaining. Don't forget, it's going to be on the video, so you don't have to take notes now, but you better do it later on. Okay? Yeah, might as well do it now. I mean, you could do it later on the video, but all right, so here we go. What's the F word too? So, debt to income, okay? Ratio. What is debt? So debt, basically, that's the amount owed. Okay, like you're in debt. Oh, hi, I owe $100. All right. Sometimes it's also the amount, the bills that are paid. On a regular basis. So that's a debt when you're like, oh, I got this, I got that, I got these bills on a regular basis. Okay. So what are some examples of debt? Sorry. Okay. What are some of examples of like bills that people pay? So, and usually debts, they can be seen on the credit report, all right? And then I'm gonna also write that down. These debts can be seen on your credit report. But what I'm going to do with we're going to include other stuff, okay? But most of these debts that you have, they're listed in your credit report, okay? So what are some of the things that could be listed in your credit report? So here are some examples of debt, okay? Some examples are like credit card bills, okay? That's a debt because you got to pay this amount, okay? What's another example that might be considered a debt? Okay, let's say you have a bank loan. Okay, that will appear in your credit report, a bank loan. How about student loans? Okay, that's another example of, okay, what about car payments? Okay, that's another one. Car payments. That's going to be, oops, car payments. Okay. Credit card bills, bank loans, student loans, car payments. What are some other stuff? Is a cable bill, only if you owe a lot. Like if you're like, if you haven't paid for like 5 months of your cable, then you're going to, it's going to show up on your credit report. All right. But regularly, no. All right. But in the examples that I gave, I included it. I just say, all right, let's just put gas bill, you know, electricity bill. But that's not your debt. Those are your regular expenses, you know. But this is more like what's going to appear on your credit report. Credit card bills, bank loans, student loans, car payment. What else could be a debt? Rent. Rent or mortgage payments. If you're buying the house and you have mortgage.
Hey, Robert,
yeah.
You forgot the
credit card bills. Yeah, thank you. Credit card bills, bank loans. Okay, you might have one or two. I don't know. Student loans, car payments, rent, mortgage payments. Okay. These are the major ones, okay? Now, the other one are like, these are things that are expense. These are just expenses like gas bill and, you know, it's not your major ones, but these are like the major ones, all right? Phone bill, you know, unless you're making payments, then it will show up on your credit card, on your credit report. Okay, so... So that's debt to income, okay? These are like the major ones. So again, debt to income. So what's income? What's this word, income? So income basically means how much you make. What do you make? All right? So income. Is what you make, the amount of money you make. Of money you make in your job, because you have to have a job at your job. At your job. And there are two types of income, okay? There are two types. There's what's called the gross income, okay? Gross, like, oh, it's gross. No, okay? It's not that kind. Gross, all right? So A is, gross income. Gross income. And then this is your net pay income, net pay. Okay. So gross income. Does anybody have heard of what gross income is? Anybody? Gross income? No? Okay. It's okay. I'm wrong. Basically, that's the amount of money. Okay. The amount of money you get at work before taxes, before they start taking away taxes. Okay. The amount of money you get before taxes. So what do you think net pay is? The net pay. Not before, but Yeah, after. The amount of money. Oops, sorry. Oh, man. The amount of. Ah. Oh, sorry, sorry, sorry. Ah. Mister. Okay, there you go. Now, let me go ahead and move this right there. Okay, the amount of. Of your pay, the amount of your paycheck, and actually it should be a paycheck, of your paycheck after taxes. So that's why this one's after. After taxes are taken away, which is called deducted, are taken away. Are taken away, okay? So, and then over here, the amount of, so it should be your paycheck before taxes are taken away, before. So basically, your gross is going to be a lot bigger. Your net pay is not, are taken away, okay? So for example, how can you remember that? So let's say you put a net, right? You put a net into the ocean. As you're writing this, you put it into the ocean, right? That's going to be your gross income because you want to get all the fishes, right? So when the net, right, comes up and catches all these fishes, it doesn't catch all the fishes, right, that are in the bottom, okay? So the whole thing is called your gross income, and the net is basically what you're going to get. So the net comes up. Okay, this is what we got. Of all the fishes in the ocean, this is what we got. Of all the money we got, after all of them disappeared and they went through the holes of the net and all that stuff, this is what we got. So in essence, this is what it means, is you grab a whole money and then all the money that drops through the net, right, is your taxes because the taxes are being paid, all right? So that's all you got to remember. So again, it's your ratio. So what's a ratio? Do you guys remember what a ratio is? Ratio? Anybody? Anybody? Come on, man. Nobody? Come on, ratio. All right, let's do it. That's right, ratio. R-A-T-I-O. Here we go. Ratio. Okay. So ratio is a comparison of two things. A comparison of two things. So here we're comparing the income, your bills to your debt, your income to your bills. So comparison of what? Two things. Okay, so it's a comparison of two things. And what are we comparing? It's usually written in a fraction, all right? It's usually written in a fraction. Okay, it's usually written in a fraction. And then convert it, then, so then what do? You divide, then convert to what's called a percent, okay? Then convert to a percent. So make sure you convert it to a percent. Okay, so here we go, to a percent. To a percent. And I'm going to show you that. Okay, to a percent. All right. So basically what we're doing is we're just going over the terminology, and then I'm going to go over like how to do it. And it's pretty easy, guys. All you have to do is add, divide, and then multiply by 100. Okay. So actually, I don't think we're going to have enough time. All right. So there's different categories. So it's a small little thing. So here's the formula. Okay. Hold on. Let me drink water. Okay. So here's the formula. So the formula. Is debt. For debt to income ratio okay, the formula is your debt payments. So here's your, so this is the formula you're going to use. All right, your debt payments divided by, so this is divide. Divided by your gross income. Gross. That's an ugly color. Gross. Oh, shoot. Okay. Your gross income. So we're going to go ahead and do a problem. Okay. So again, and I'm going to give you the steps. All right. Because this is the formula that you're going to use, and it'll take you like 5 minutes to do one problem, even less. This is the formula. Sorry, guys. Right here. So remember, this is means divide. Divide. All right. So how do you do this? All right. So let's go ahead and do a problem. Okay. Oh, what happened there? Oh, it got smaller. That's pretty cool. All right, debt to income. Oh, hey. So let's pick someone's name. Let's say Larry. Okay. So Larry has an earning. Let's say $2,756 gross income. Okay, that's his gross income. That's what he makes before taxes. Okay. His debt are, and these are his debts. So give me something that he would be paying. He would be paying rent. Can someone give me an amount? How much? Rent. Give me some hundreds. Anybody? $350. $350? Oh, man. Okay, that's fine. There's no such thing as... That's all good. It's all right. It's all good. $350 rent. Okay. Let's say he was a student, and he has a student loan. How much is a student loan? Can someone just tell me? Give me an amount. Okay, $110. There you go. Student loan. Credit card. He has credit card bills he has to make. And he owes a lot of money. So how much does he owe in his credit card? Somebody. $10,000. Ah, hey, but that's more than what he's making. That's more than this. Let's make it a little lower.
$1,200.
Okay, $1,200. $1,200. He owes $1,200. Ah, okay. And one more. Let's pick one more. Cell phone. How much does he pay a month? The cell. No, let's say 85 bucks a month. All right. So, and this is what they do. The banks say, okay, you got good credit. Good. You got the money down payment. Good. Wait. We're going to lend you money. Let's see your debt to income. Let's see if you can still make payments. Because if you have all these bills, how do we know that you could pay our bill, right? So what do? The first step you do is you add up all your debts. Okay? Step one, add up debts. That's pretty easy. Okay? Let me put it back over here. Step one, add up your debts. So I'm going to do step one. All right? So I'm going to write it here. Step one. Add up debts. Add up all debts. So you got to add them all up. How hard is that? It's not hard. So what's your debt? Jason Valdez, give me one of the debts that he owes that we wrote down on the word problem. Give me one. Jason Valdez. Yeah, but what is that? What is that?
Rent.
Yeah. So the rent, $350, right? So that is, so we have to add the rent, $350. Very good, Jason Valdez. So $350. So I'm going to write $350. What else am I going to write? Michael, what's another debt that he owes? It's right here. I wrote him. Jason Valdez said rent. Huh? How much? That's all you got to do is add all your debts. 110. What?
I don't know math.
Well, that's why you could go back to the recording. This is not math. This is just how are you going to survive in life? You know, you're going to get paid and they're going to be like, oh, that's your, it's like, wait, sir. Well, that's why I'm asking you is pick out, you got to know if you're going to do it on your phone, you got to know what you're going to be adding. Right. So you got to add your student loan. What's another one? Credit card. That's how much they're paying. Oops. Sorry. So credit card. That's another one. So we're going to add the credit card. $1,200. Okay. And is there another one? Another debt?
The cell phone,
$85. All right. Go ahead. Use your calculator. Add them all up. What do you get? Use your calculator. There you go. See, you could use your calculator, but you got to know what you need to add up. Right? So where's my... Anybody?
$1,745.
Let me see. Hold on. Because I got to find out. Hold on. I want to make sure. Hey, watch your language. No, you're not. Just got to use your fingers. So it's $1,745. That's how much his bills every month. This is what he has to pay. Okay, this is his debt. All right. Now, step two is now we're going to divide. We're going to use a formula. Remember the formula right here? We're going to use this formula. We're going to get that number and then divide it by the gross income. That's it. Okay. We're going to get that number that we got and divide it by the, oops. All right. We're going to get this number, all right, and divide it by the gross income. Okay. So what's the gross income? So I'm going to go sideways. Now I'm going to go 2756. There it is. Okay. 2756. Hold on. 2756. All right. So here we go. I'm going to go a little bit. All right. Step two. 2756. Step two. Use a formula. I tell you, go ahead and use a formula. So use the formula. Use debt to income formula. All right. The D is for debt to income. DTI. Okay. So 2756. So here we go. 2756. So 1745. So remember, the formula is debt divided by the gross income. I'll put I and C. See that? Your debt. And that's what we just calculated right here. This is your debt. Okay, so that's right there. See that? And divided by the gross income, where did you get that? From the word problem. Where is it? It's up here. Okay, right there. See that? 2756. So that's all we're doing. You're adding and dividing. Hold on. 2756. So what do we, oh man. So what do we get? What do we get? Use your calculator now. Here we go. 1745 divided by 2756. So what is that? Basically, that is 0.633. Just use three digits. That's fine. But remember, debt to income is a percent. So now what's step three? I got to change that to percent. So step three, convert to percent. And what does that mean? Multiply by 100. Multiply by 100. So again, so we get this number, okay? Your debt to income, you get this number, and you're going to use that right there, bam. Okay? So let me go ahead. Go down a little bit, 0.633, by 0.633, and then multiply by 100, 0.633, and you multiply by 100. And what does that give you? If you multiply 0.633, multiply by 100, use your calculators, okay? Go ahead, you guys have anything? Anybody? 63.3 is correct. Okay. So that means, what does that mean? So that means if I were to do this, that means, what does that mean visually? So if I were to do a box, right? And here is 0%. And here is 100%. Okay, that means 63% of my income is used to pay bills. 63% of my income is used to pay bills. So you're going to go up to basically, let me get a different one. Let's do red. Where's red? 63%. So where would 63% fall? It would fall about 50, about right there. That's 63% right there. What does that mean? 63% of my bills? No, of my income, sorry. Pays bills. That's what it means. So is that good? That 63, most of your income. So this is basically, this is money to spend. Right? Just a little bit. So if I were a lender, hey, no, you know what? You're making this much and 63% of your income pays bills. Nah, sorry. I can't give you a loan for the house. Sorry. Unless you cut stuff. All right. You guys understand that? So let's go back real quick. Let me go ahead and pause it. Okay. Let me pause the video real quick because I'm going to review a little bit. No, well, let's just keep going. It doesn't matter. All right. What does this mean? Again, 63% of your income pays bills. That's why it's called debt to income. How much debt do you have compared to your income? Let's compare these two things. Your debt to your income. All right. And that's what it means. That's what they're going to look for. All right. You want to make, okay, but what's your debt to income? How much do you make? All right. Let's see your bills. Hey, your credit report says you got these. All right, let's add them up. Uh-oh. So what are the percentage breakdowns? Okay. So if you, so this one was what, 63%? So I'm going to go ahead and give you the breakdown. All right. So again, what do you do first? Add up all your debts. Step number one, right here, add up all your debts. That was easy. Step two, divide by your income, right? Use this one right here. Use that number and divide by your income, okay? And then multiply by 100 so you could change it to a percent, all right? And 63%. What does that mean? 63% of your income pays bills. That's a lot. So basically, there's a breakdown. The book has this, all right? If your answer, okay, so here are guidelines. So debt to income guidelines. Debt to income guidelines, all right? And this is from a book. I don't know if it's accurate, but let's just use that guidelines. All right. This is the way it works. So, sorry. And I didn't stop the recording. So debt. Oh, sorry. One more. All right. Here we go. Debt to income guidelines. All right. So here we go. So number one, if you get your answer and you have, if you go from zero to 36%, guess what that is? They're going to say, you know what? You have a good, healthy. So this is your health. It's called healthy debt load. Debt load. That means you're good. Okay. Yeah, you're good. You're not using a lot of your income to pay bills. You're good. You know, you don't have a lot of bills. So that's good. So it's healthy. It's like an A. This is excellent. All right. So this is good. So I'll put good. So this is good. No, it's not good. It's excellent. This is like, oh yeah, all right, you good. You don't have a lot of bills. So this is excellent. That means that your income is not paying a lot of your bills. All right. You got room. So all right, we'll go. Then if you have 37%, let me do another one. Bam. If you have 37% all the way to 42%, then they're going to say, that's like a B. They're going to say, begin reducing your debt. Start paying some of your bills completely. Begin reducing. Mean paying more of this, pay more of that. Begin reducing your debt. Okay. So this is excellent. Good. So we'll put good here. This is good. Okay. It's good. Not excellent, but it's good. You know, but pay some of your stuff. All right. So far, so good. And then the next one is 43 to 49. 43% of 49. They're going to tell you, careful. It says be likely in financial trouble. Likely in financial trouble. That's almost 50% of your income. It pays bills. So if you make $100, 50 of those dollars is going to go pay bills. No. Likely in financial trouble. Financial trouble. Okay, you guys understand it? So again, going back in case you're so this is careful. This one's this one's This one's more like This is more like Oh man, you know? All right. So far so good. So this one you're likely in financial trouble. And then the other one, the last one is 50%. If 50% of your income is paying bills, 50% plus, if 50% of your income is paying bills, like I said, if you make $100 and $50 is just going to bills, you only have $50, right? So there, that's saying, danger zone. Boop, boop, boop. Danger, danger. So that's the danger zone. Wait, that's a song. Danger zone. Hold on, danger zone. Danger zone. Danger zone. I don't know. Yeah, danger zone. Here we go. Danger. Danger zone. Danger, danger. Dangerous finance, dangerous, danger zone. bad one. All right, here we go. Danger zone. So here we go. So you should go back. So remember, here are the categories. Death to income guidelines. 0 to 36%. That's a healthy debt load. That's excellent. Good. Good. 37 to 42. It's okay. Start reducing. Start reducing. Start paying some of the bills. 43 to 49, likely in financial trouble. And 50 higher, danger zone. Nah. Alright. So that's your danger zone. So that's kind of what we're doing today. It's basically, yeah, it's a lot of notes, but this is gonna prepare us for the work. You need to know this stuff. All right. So what does that mean, Mister? Like, can I see it? Yeah. So here's the visual. Okay. Here's the visual. All right. Did I stop recording? No, huh? No, I don't think I did. All right. So here we go. So here's the visual. Here's your income. All right. So this is your income, 100% of your income. Okay. This is how much money you make. Oh, let me put it right here in the middle. Right here. Income. Okay. Just so you could get a sense of what I mean. Here's your income. All of this, right? All of this. And let me go ahead and highlight it. All of this is your income. Oh, where's it? So all of this is your income. Okay. All this. All right. This is your income. So what happens? All right. The income, this is all your money. All right. So let's say it's $100. You make $100. All right. So your income every month is $100. All right. So what they're saying is from 0 to 36, from 0 to, let's say, 36 right here. 0 to 36. Bills. That's pretty good, right? You're only paying this amount of your income is bills. That's pretty good. Yeah? Okay. So now let's do another one. Okay. Here's another one. Oh, let me erase it. So this is so that you could see it. Like, okay, I get it. That's pretty good. Because then you have all this free money, right? So now let's do another one. And the same thing, you make $100, and the next one is 37 to 42. So up to 42. So from 0 up to like 42. That's 42. And then they're saying 37. So let's say it's right there. 37. So that means that all this and this pays bills. Oh man, more, you see? So from 37 to 42, that's this category. So you go up and then boom. That's the second one. Ah, I don't know about you, right? And then the next one is 43 to 49. So I'll do another one. 43 to 49. Up to 49. So 0. So up to like 49 is probably right here. 49. Oh, hey. ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? Hold on. All right, here we go. Just kidding. All right, so 49%. That means that all this, guys, I'll put in pink. All this is paying bills from your $100. 49, that's like, no. I can't give you a loan. You see that? all your income is paying bills. This is paying bills. So I'm going to put right here bills. This is for bills. Oh, man. So that only gives you a little bit of room. Nah, that's too much, right? Right? So $49. And then the last one is what? Another one. And this is just so that you could see what I mean by the numbers. They're saying 50% higher. So 50%. At least that 50%. This one actually is what? 43? So 43. So this is the other one right there. So, okay. 43 up to, and this one's more. So that's like, what? I'll use this blue. So that's what it means. This means all this, 50% danger zone. And then this is going to be the danger zone right here. Danger. So it's 50% or higher. Danger zone. See all that? That means that a lot of it is paying what? Your bills. I'm not going to lend you money if your debt to income is like that. Why am I going to? I'm not going to lend you money. This is all for bills. Right? And that's it. Now, I won't have time. I did one example. So where would the other one fall? Where would that answer fall? If I were to go over here, the problem that we did, what did we get on the problem? What did we get? Anybody? We got what? 63%, right? So where would that fall under? 63.3. If I go down, it would fall under which one? Are you guys awake? Stop texting. I know some of you guys are texting. It would be in the danger zone. Yes, right here. It would be like, nah, you know what? 63% of your income, what you're going to make is paying bills? No. Which one is, I will feel comfortable if they got the smaller percent, right? And that's it. All right. So I'm not going to give you work. We did one problem. All right. So on Wednesday, we're just going to do the work. All right. And I'll probably give you like five problems. So what are we doing? We're adding, dividing, and multiply by 100. That's it. It'll take you like 10 minutes. But remember, it took us long because you needed to understand what it meant by debt to income. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording. All right. Hold on. Music. Music, where is it? Oh, yeah. All right, here we go. Yeah.